Mr. and Mrs. North, starring Barbara Britton and Richard Denning.
What do you want?
Oh, here is the list for the lonely grocery and the dismal vegetables. I also like to have $1 million, a year's vacation, and you.
You watch your language.
Maggie!
Oh, don't put me down!
Hey, is that any way for a bride to act?
I'm not your bride.
Well, you will be in a few hours. It's all set.
Well, then unset it. I'm sorry, John, but I can't.
Can't?
Well, I didn't hear from you for so many years, I thought.
5 years, I know. Those years were spent in the pen, Maggie.
Oh.
It taught me a lot. It made me realize you were the most important thing in my life. I used to dream at night about this day. The day I claimed you as my wife.
Oh, no, John, please.
Oh, don't worry. I'm not in the racket anymore. The old big John you knew is gone.
I'm glad, for your sake. But I can't marry you, John. It's impossible. Try and understand.
Look, let's talk this over.
Oh, Mr. and Mrs. North, welcome back. Thanks, Miss McGinnis.
We've been looking forward to this for a whole year.
Oh, this is Mr. Thornton. John, meet Mr. and Mrs. North, my favorite guest. How do you do,
Mr. Thornton? Say, is Francois still your chef?
Of course.
Oh, Mr. and Mrs. North, I recognize your car outside. Madame North. Monsieur!
Francois!
It is such a pleasure to see you. Hello, greetings.
Wait, don't tell me. Un, deux, trois, quatre, cinq, number fifth, honeymoon.
That's right. Francois, I just have to leave your rooms. Will you excuse me? Of course.
Ah, quel amour, what love. This reminds me of the springtime in Paris.
Oh, we remember Paris, all right. We also remember your cooking.
Oh, I'll say. For a year, I've been dreaming of your sauces and gravies and lobsters and champagne.
Ah, man who dreams like that, he appreciates the art of living.
And the snails and garlic, and the kidneys in port.
And you in the hospital.
What death could be more blissful than from eating?
Well, I guess it depends on who's cooking.
Oh, I adore you, darling, but even you don't enjoy your cooking.
I know, Donut, you're right. I guess I need some lessons, Francois.
I think I hear something in the kitchen is bumbling. Hey, cow eyes, scram in the kitchen.
You wanted to talk. Now, what is it, John?
Is it Frank?
Yes.
I'll soon change that. When he hears what I've got to tell him about you, he'll drop you like a hot potato.
It won't work. I've already told him everything. We have no secrets from each other.
That's real touching. Did you tell him about the box?
The box?
The safe deposit box. The one that's in both our names. The one you're paying rent for. You've got the key to it.
What about it?
Don't horse around, Maggie. There's almost $50,000 in that box, cold cash.
I don't believe it.
It's the truth.
Racket money, and you hid it in my name. I could have wound up in jail myself.
That money was for us. I didn't do it to put you on the spot.
That's where I've been, on the spot every day for 5 years. And you tried to tell me you love me.
All right, all right. Give me the key. I'll get you off the hook.
The key? Frank's got that, too.
What? You're joking.
No, I gave him everything. My bank books, the hotel papers, the key. I still have the rent receipts on the box, but...
Why, you must have been out of your mind.
He's got everything. Everything.
Afternoon, Francois.
Ah, this is Sheriff Logan. Hello, Frank. How's the business of crime?
Guess it's here to stay. How's the cooking business?
Ah, I cook. People eat. People stop eating. I stop cooking. Then we all out of business. Why, Mademoiselle Margaret, she is out, but she gonna be back shortly.
I didn't come to see her today.
No? Who else?
Maybe you.
Me? Gastronomically or officially?
It's official, Francois. Sometimes it ain't no fun being sheriff. No fun at all. Sometimes it faces a man with a mighty unpleasant duty.
Yeah, like a husband who has to go home to the wife he don't love it.
The sûreté, the French police?
Yeah, sure is.
Yeah, well, whatever it is, they want you.
Me? But I am so unimportant and just a little onion in the chicken fricassee.
His extradition papers. Bigamy.
Oh, looks like this time Francois, he is cooked. Oh, beg your pardon.
We'd best go now.
Oh, no. No, no, not till I'm finished my coq au vin.
You haven't any choice.
Oh, no, 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 no. But you don't stop an artist in the middle of brushstroke. When my coq au vin is finished, his positivity is a masterpiece. So you wait. You wait. Come on. Come on, now you wait, and while you wait, you eat. It's only taken a couple, 2-3 hours.
Well, I reckon it wouldn't hurt to let you finish it at that. Always knew you were romantic, Gus, but I sure never figured you for 4 wives.
You never spent it 4 springtime in Paris. poor Francois. I never can say no to a lady. His wife 3 more, which I divorced. What expenses.
Uh-huh. Well, which one's gonna get you? They all want you back.
You can put the names in a hat. I don't mind to go to jail. But to go back to those women, never. Never I go back to those women.
You don't have any choice.
Oh.
Ah, you are back.
Yeah. Any trouble, Francois?
Trouble. They start in the cradle and end in a coffin.
I guess you're right. Where's Agnes?
Well, she's setting the tables for dinner.
Oh.
Oh, no. I do this for you.
Oh, thank you, Francois.
Yeah, you are tired and you want to get clean up for dinner.
Oh, have you seen Sheriff Logan?
No, I don't see the sheriff today.
Oh, well, he'll get here in time for dinner. He always does.
does what he has to do.
On moonlight ride, I fall overboard for the girl. I am through with a woman.
Now, that's not the attitude, Francois.
Oh, Mrs. North, I don't know. It must be you.
So I gathered. Here, let me help you.
Oh, no, not with my cocoa vat. Now, tomorrow you take first lesson, but tonight you just watch. Mm-hmm.
All right, tonight I watch. Mm. Blood. Oh, Francois, you made an awful mess here. You really should butcher those chickens outside.
Give me the towel. I clean them up.
Well, at least I can help you put these away.
No, I need these on the outside. Maybe you help me with the cocoa van.
Oh, can I? How wonderful.
I may not be a king, but I've just eaten like one.
I think some brandy would be just right to celebrate your fifth honeymoon. I've been saving a special bottle for you in the pantry.
Oh, wonderful.
She's fainted. Get some water.
Water.
Jerry, is he...
Yes. Better call the sheriff.
He's no use. That is the sheriff.
We'll take her up to her room so she can rest. I'll call the sheriff's deputy if he has one.
Doesn't it seem strange to you, Miss McGinnis, fainting that way? She doesn't seem the type.
Now, Pam, don't
stop. Well, I was just wondering.
You know, Pam, I was just... Pam? Pam?
Jerry, look. The killer must have dropped it. The chain's broken.
It looks like a wedding ring.
Initials.
F.L.
F.L. Jerry, what's Francois's last name?
F.L.
Hmm? Lycopopolis. Oh, no, not Francois.
Of course, that's why he kept me from going into the pantry.
No, Pam, he couldn't. Francois isn't a killer. Besides, he's not married.
No?
I can't believe it.
You're thinking of his cooking. Of course he's married now, but I know who to.
To whom? Who?
Margaret. Whom else?
Who else? Oh, no, Pam.
And I'll bet if someone were to look in his room, they'd find a marriage license.
Pam, you wouldn't.
And the license would be made out to Francois and Margaret, too.
My darling wife, will you please stop this? For one thing, you're completely wrong, and for another, it's none of your...
How do you know?
Well, it's just that... That is it?
Uh-huh.
Hey, what's the matter with her?
I gave her a sedative.
Well, I'm not through questioning her yet.
You're through.
Hey, now, look here. I'm the deputy sheriff around here.
Only for you.
Yeah? Well, it's mighty suspicious you putting her to sleep before I finish questioning her.
Why don't you relax, Sonny?
Sonny? Huh.
John? You searched my room this afternoon.
Well, Maggie, I didn't.
Didn't need to bother. I'd have shown them to you.
Maggie, I...
Don't lie to me. I know you were here.
Well, what's the difference? Oh, look, Maggie, let's not fight. Oh, sweetheart, I love you so, I... Look. Take this ring. We'll be married whenever you say so.
It's very pretty and very expensive. But it hardly explains why you searched the room.
All right.
I'll leave it here. We'll be married whenever you say. And we'll talk it over when you're not so upset.
Sheriff Logan really loved this smelly old pipe. Yes, it's funny how a man becomes attached to a pipe.
You were very fond of him, weren't you?
I sure was. He practically brang me up.
How long have you been sheriff?
Oh, I'd say, now let's see. About 10 years, yep, 10 years.
And how long have you been with him?
I've been Sheriff Logan's deputy for 5 years.
Yeah, darn this cold.
There's something wrong about this.
Wrong about what?
Well, why is this key ring open? Did the murderer take one of his keys?
Well, I don't know. But I do see that his wallet's missing. You know, he kept all of his official papers in it. And he pinned a star on the outside. That was the motive, all right. Plain robbery.
Why would anyone rob the sheriff? Did he have so much money?
Just his salary. You know how much a sheriff makes.
Now, who do you suppose would want to kill Sheriff Logan?
I don't know. The sheriff didn't have an enemy in the world.
And you say he didn't have any money?
Not enough to cause anyone to want to kill him.
I see. You both lived around here for a long while, haven't you?
Yes, ma'am. The sheriff and I were both born and raised right here in this county.
What was that, Chief?
Oh, don't worry. It's nothing, my little pigeon. Oh, don't you worry now. You leave everything to Francois next time.
You know, Sheriff, you've been working pretty hard. I think it's very much nice you have a little French tapestry.
Yeah, don't mind if I do.
Agnes, bring the sheriff a glass of milk. You know something, Mrs. North? I think so it'd be awful much nice if tonight maybe we're going to make the marinade of the beef.
That would be wonderful. Oh, Jerry loves your Mary. If I could learn how to cook it, he'd be tickled pink.
Hey, what are you trying to do?
Oh, qu'est-ce que c'est? What happened?
Never mind the double talk. Tell me what you're trying to do putting this... The sheriff's wallet.
Are you sure?
Sure, I'm sure. He's trying to sneak it back in with the sheriff's thing.
Oh, no, I find it in the pocket.
Oh, you found it in your pocket, huh? You expect me to believe that story?
Oh, you're wrong, monsieur.
Yeah.
You're wrong.
Well, you're under arrest for murder.
Taking those papers?
They're mine. Some letters from my business files.
That isn't true. One of them's a marriage license and the others are receipts for a safety deposit box. Did the sheriff have the key to that?
Well, I don't quite know what you're talking about.
There was a key missing from the sheriff's key ring, and he and Maggie were secretly married.
Why, Mrs. North, you've been reading too many detective stories.
Excuse me, I want to find my husband. Oh, Agnes. Have you seen Mr. North?
I think Mr. North took a stroll down to the lake. He said he was going there. Thank you.
To scream, Mrs. North. Your husband is way down by the lake.
What are you going to do?
You know too much.
You killed Frank Logan.
I said you know too much.
Francois keeps that shotgun for chicken thieves. It was only loaded with rock salt. He'll have a nice mess of blisters, though, but they'll heal up in time for him to sit in an electric chair.
Midnight snack. Oh, Francois, this is more like a seven-day feast.
Permit me. I'm Pierre Toussaint of the French Sûreté. Sheriff Logan was to deliver Francois.
Wait, you mean Francois is under arrest?
Oui. His wives are pressing charges to bigamy. I have here the original extradition papers.
Only on one condition I make the surrender. I return to the jail, but not to those wives. The crime is not called for such terrific punishment.
Oh, calm yourself. Already Paris jails is awaiting your arrival to replace that abominable cook. A wretch of a man whose cooking entitles him only to the guillotine.
You see, mes amis, I have nothing else to do but say goodbye.
Oh, the rabbit. Let him simmer and turn him off in half hour. Yes?
I think I take a hamburger for the trip.
Well, Jerry, can't you do something?
Like what?
Madame North. Au revoir. Monsieur North. So long, sport. Goodbye, friend. I surrender.
Après vous, monsieur.
Avec plaisir. Adieu.
Mr. and Mrs. North is directed by Ralph Francis Murphy, a John W. Loveton production. Produced by Federal Telefilms. Starring Barbara Britton and Richard Denning, featuring Francis DeSales. This has been a film presentation.